Hi, everybody. This is Ken Corbin, and welcome once again to the Manufactured Home Show. This is where I have the opportunity to interview the absolute best in our industry, from retailers to suppliers and lenders and manufacturers. And today, my dear friend, Mary Beth Manelli from Triad, and she will be meeting you in just a moment, and you are going to be really excited about what she has to say. But before we begin, and as always, if you have any questions whatsoever, maybe you know someone that you might recommend should be on the program, like Mary Beth, or maybe you want to be on the program, simply drop me an email to ken@callkencorbin.com. And if you want to see not only this interview with Mary Beth, but all the interviews in this series, you can do a few things. You can go to my website, and it's callkencorbin.com. And then just click on the upper right-hand side, and you'll see a tab that says Manufactured Home Show. You can click on that tab. You can go to Learn MH, click on the tab that says Videos. You can go to YouTube and do a search. And of course, my business Facebook page, which is Ken Corbin Speaker, and you'll see all the interviews. But with that, let me introduce my dear friend, Mary Beth, who has almost 40 years of experience in the insurance industry, today specializing in manufactured housing. Her incredible career ranges from working with smaller firms as a licensed agent to her position today as Vice President and Insurance Director at Triad Financial Services. And of course, we all know Triad is one of the premier lender in the manufactured housing industry, and they're doing business and serving 48 states across the US. But today, Mary Beth will not only talk about and explain the current products and services that Triad is offering, but the new and exciting trends that she sees going forward. Ladies and gentlemen, with that, I am tickled. I am so pleased to introduce to you and have you meet one of the beautiful people in our industry. Mary Beth, how are you doing today?
I'm fine, thank you, Ken. Thanks very much for having me. And with that introduction, that lovely introduction, but the 40 years lets everyone know that I'm no spring chicken. So,
well, yeah,
I have a lot of experience. So
you've been around so long. And we were talking before we started this. And we were laughing about the meeting just a year ago. We were looking at both of our Facebook pages, you know, how it pops up and it talks about just a year ago. Yes. We had dinner with Sam Huffman, of course, and some dealers. And we were at Ruth Chris Steakhouse in New Orleans, had a wonderful meal. Mm-hmm. And we were talking about the local culture in the area. And you went on this crazy trip. And I've showed this picture, I don't know to how many people, you guys went out and were looking for alligators. And there was this, you got to tell people about the trip. Tell us all about it.
Well, I was with Sam Huffman and Linda Pearson and Larissa Davis now from Triad. And they were all psyched to go on this alligator watching cruise. And I was scared to death. But it turned out that it was pretty fun. It was chilly. It was fun. And, you know, Sam, I think, was delighted that I was scared to death. But it was a great time. And it was something that I never, ever thought I'd do. But they encouraged me to go. And we fed raw chicken to, well, we didn't. But they fed raw chicken to the alligators, and they had little baby ones for people to hold. Again, it was not me, but the other girls did, and it was just great. It was just one of those things that Sam is wonderful. When we get, you know, to be with him, he took us to the Mardi Gras Museum down there, the Parade Museum, and he's just a wonderful host when you go visit with him. So
he is.
One of my better trips for sure.
I tell frequently the story of late last year and the early part of this year, before all this COVID nonsense hit. Mm-hmm. Sam and I had the opportunity to travel throughout Louisiana, his home state. And every night we would go to a different restaurant throughout the state, be it, you know, Lake Charles, be it Baton Rouge, be it Hammond, Lafayette, it makes no difference. Every time we seen that we walked into a restaurant, it was like watching the O's Cheers program, and they say, hey, Sam, everybody knows Sam. So yeah. it was fantastic.
Well, he's great. He's great for our industry. He's great with me. He's helped me, certainly introduced me to so many dealers. He's just a pleasure to work with.
So. He is a joy. Well, yeah. let's talk about you just for a second. I mean, everybody has something that inspired them that said, hey, you know, this is the switch that's going to make me get involved with the manufactured housing business. Tell us a little bit about what got you involved.
Well, I actually, I don't know that I got into it intentionally. I worked for Textron Financial many, many years ago.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, as you know, in the finance industry, a lot of the people bounce around from companies to companies. And as some companies close, they move along. Well, I was contacted by Lee Dickerson, another one of my great fellow employees and friends. And, he asked me if I'd be interested in coming to talk to Triad about working on an open lot inventory program for them because they were getting into the floor plan financing and they wanted to have a program that would complement the finance. Mm-hmm. So I met with the Glissons, and this was going back about 8 years ago, and we hit it off, and I did some consulting for them for a couple of years. We put together a program. At the time, it was with Lloyd's of London, and it's been wonderful ever since. About 5-6 years ago, I became an employee of Triad, so a permanent employee. I hope it's permanent. But anyway, that's been great. We still have the open lot program. It's now with a different carrier. It's with Zurich, mm-hmm. and through Lockton Insurance Brokers. But anyway, that was really how I got into it. It wasn't my plan. I'm delighted I did. It's a wonderful industry, and I couldn't ask for a better place to work. You know, the people.
Oh, yeah. Are great. I mean, what you've done, I mean, the accolades that you've received, because this was an all new venture for Triad. They had no idea about this. And you came along, and you took that experience from Textron, and you brought that over. But, you know, we all have probably we'll call it our favorite part of the industry, you know, be it the people, you know, be it the products, be it the servicing. Just from your perspective, Mary Beth, what would you say is the thing that you enjoy the most about it?
For me, I'd have to say it's the people, because I've been in the insurance industry, like you said, for over 40 years. And in the insurance or in the manufactured home industry, you really get to know this group of dealers and communities and the folks that I work with and people like you and Sam and just everybody, that it's like a big family, and everybody is concerned. I want to say looks out for everyone else, but everyone's concerned that, and they want to see that the other people in the industry do well. You know, there's competition naturally. Competition's a very good thing, but, you know, I just think that the people, they couldn't be nicer. It's a lot of my dealers, they're family run operations, and I've become friends with, I can't tell you how many. So it's that. And I know earlier you mentioned about when this COVID thing gets over, man, I can't wait until we have our first in-person convention just to see the people again, because that's what, every time you see the people, it just makes you more proud to be in the industry, but it just makes it, it's just a wonderful thing when you see all those people.
You know, you're right. And again, we were chatting earlier. It looks like the Louisville show, which has been held like forever, will be held this year, but it'll likely be one of the virtual events. Similar to the one that was recently done for SECO out of Atlanta. And then for those of our viewers and listeners who aren't aware, the Tunica show is now officially moved, and it will be in Biloxi, Mississippi. And we all are really hoping that Biloxi will be live, because it is an incredible place for a venue. Yeah. I mean, you have the You have the golf, you have the water, you have the beautiful weather. It's an incredible city, vibrant, the gambling, the restaurants, all the activities. So, I mean, it's going to be really, really exciting. But let me ask you this, and you've been in this industry now for a while. You've been in the insurance industry for a very long time. Some people call them challenges. I like to call them opportunities. But there are going to be some things that will be different, that will be a challenge or an opportunity on the horizon over the next few years.
Yeah.
And from Mary Beth, from your perspective, what do you see that we should be looking for?
Well, the biggest challenge, I think, for me and for my team, who I have a wonderful team at Triad, but the biggest challenge for me is being able to write property coverage for dealers for their inventory, for homeowners, with the catastrophic losses that we've suffered over the last few years. The insurance companies are all pulling back because they don't want to write, or they can't absorb the property losses that they have been exposed to, or they can absorb them, I guess, but it's really raising the rates and that kind of thing for all the insureds. So my biggest thing is to be able to provide affordable coverage, to be able to provide flood coverage for folks in flood zones. It's very difficult to get wind coverage for dealers that are, you know, down near New Orleans and you know, Harris County, Texas, and that kind of thing. So that's the challenge. The challenge is trying to find affordable coverage for the dealers, protect them, and to be able to provide homeowners coverage for insurance, where if we're in an affordable housing industry, we need to have affordable insurance. We can't have insurance that's going to cost a lot to these people. So that's the biggest challenge. And I love a challenge, but it's been, it has been really something the past year or so.
Well, and I know recently we've talked about, you know, unfortunately, all the various claims that have come in from the storms. And just earlier this week, I was in Lake Charles, Louisiana.
Oh, yeah.
Where they were hit twice within 6 weeks. And the devastation was tremendous. I saw them driving down I-10. And large billboards are just knocked over.
Yeah, we were very fortunate. I mean, we did have some personal lines, homeowners claims. We fared very well from a dealer perspective. We've got some great dealers down in the Lake Charles area, and we actually expected that hurricane to go further up than that. But we were very fortunate that our claims were small. Sure. And the insurance company was very proactive. They jumped right out there. So they're working the claims, and I believe that they're all squared away now. But one of the things that we were able to do on our open lot program is that we have a great coverage on our policy that in the event that the dealers have a heads up that there's going to be some sort of catastrophic weather coming up, if they can take any kind of precautions to either move the homes, which sometimes is impractical, but anything that they can do to help mitigate the losses, our insurance carrier will provide coverage up to $50,000 with no deductible. Wow. And they don't have to be hit by the claim. So it's really something that, we encourage dealers. I typically send out a note prior to a big loss to remind them that this coverage is here. So take advantage of it. The carrier wants you to use it. They'd much rather have a $50,000 loss than a multi-million dollar loss if there's any way that they can, you know, prevent that. So,
you know, that's terrific.
It's something that we just
before.
Got this year. So
yeah,
it's
a
cool
fantastic.
Thing. Yeah.
Well, you've been there for now a total of 8 years. Six years as an employee, two you mentioned as the consultant.
Yep.
I'm hoping that you're going to continue to do that. And what is your plan over the next? What's your plan next 3, 4, 5 years?
Oh, 3, 4, 5 years is to continue what I'm doing. I mean, there's a lot to be done. Stay the course. There's a lot. There's things that I'm working on now. Everything that I do, from a program standpoint, and I love a challenge. I really do. And so when someone says you can't do it, that's, you know, don't tell me I can't, because I can. And, you know, you just have to have patience and it will happen. So right now, you know, I'm working on a program that it may take a year, or I don't think so, but, you know, I have a lot to do and I have a lot that I want to accomplish before I ride off into the sunset. So,
well, can you share with us anything new that you're specifically working on right now? Is there any special things, or it's kind of top secret stuff? Or?
Well, it's not top secret. The thing is, when I work on something, I have partners in the industry that I work with that are really valuable to me. In particular, I have, I've mentioned the Lockton folks that have my open lot program, but I work with a group that's called InsureMark. It's a division of Aon. And they worked with me 5 or 6 years ago to put together our homeowners program, which has been just outstanding. We've rolled it out nationally and we provide coverage. We don't specifically only write coverage for Triad customers. We will provide coverage for anyone who needs it, because there's not a lot of agents and carriers that work in the MH field. So our homeowners program that we put together is just great, because we can provide coverage, including flood and wind, everywhere in the country. What they're doing for me now is my good friend over there, Tim McCoy, he is working on a flood program for me. Aon currently has an easy flood program for traditional stick-built buildings and commercial and all that kind of stuff. But they're working to put together a standalone flood product that will... it will be the same form as the NFIP, the National Flood Program. It will be affordable. It will be something that we can, it's a streamlined process that we can do it same day quoting, same day binding. And the big deal is that we won't require, they won't require elevation certificates. And that is a huge deal.
It is.
For our consumers, because if there isn't an elevation certificate, it costs anywhere from $400 to $600 to get someone out there to make the inspection and handle that. So again, the whole idea is to keep insurance affordable for people that are buying homes. So that's going to be a big deal for the consumers. It's going to be a big deal for the dealers, because it will push along the process of closing their deals. They won't have to wait possibly for a week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks for elevation certificate information. And it's going to be great for our lenders. We have a lot of lender partners that they from time to time will call me looking for standalone flood coverage for their consumers. And again, they may not be Triad, but they look to us for a solution. And so that's going to be a big deal. And I'm truly hoping we've been working on it for about 6 months now. I think after the first of the year, it'll be something that we'll roll out.
Okay, so let me make sure I understand. So what you're saying is they do not have to be a Triad customer necessarily to handle or purchase some of the products that you offer, which I think is wonderful.
Yeah, it is good, because, I mean, initially when Triad had an insurance agency that was just to work with their consumers. Mm-hmm. And, but the thing was that we had so many people calling for help, whether it was another agent or it was dealers. And we just felt as though it would be beneficial to us to be able to write more business. Mm-hmm. And, but the big thing is that it only helps the industry if we work with everyone. And I've worked with other dealers that have participated in the programs that I have. We have dealers now that go directly to some of the carriers that I had a proprietary program to, like InsureMark. They're able to work with them. So I work with InsureMark to help other dealers have access to these programs. So it's just the right thing to do, you know? So yeah, we can provide coverage, whether it's on the consumer side, whether it is for the homeowners or for their warranties. We do a lot of warranties, 5-year warranties on new homes. And, But on the open lot program, we can provide coverage for dealers for open lot coverage nationally. Wow. So we encourage dealers to contact us for a quote. A lot of insurance companies, as I said, because of the cat exposure, they've pulled back on some of the flood and wind coverage. And a lot of times we're able to help them when they can't get help from their existing agent.
Well, and I want to kind of go back to something that you mentioned earlier about the meetings, the conventions, you know, the mm-hmm. get-togethers. And you were so right that this industry is really unique, that even though we may be competitors, they're still our peers. And it's so nice that we can sit down and talk yeah. with everyone and share information and utilize some best practices methods.
Right.
I'm assuming you're seeing that as well.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I deal with some of the largest communities in the country that, you know, the agents that sometimes they have agencies that they own, but we talk about the problems of the industry, because if I have a solution and I can tell them what it is, you know, it works both ways. Or if I'm trying to figure out something like, oh, maybe we could do this. You know, if it's something that it's already out there, but I'm just not aware of it, I'd much rather have someone tell me than have me spin my wheels.
Yeah.
So, but it's great. I mean, I've had a lot of agents, you know, help me along the way, and it's just great. It's great fun.
In all your years in this industry, in looking back in that 2020 hindsight.
Yeah.
What would you say is the one thing perhaps that you could share with us that you're the most proud of?
Oh, for me, it's being given the opportunity. And if it wasn't for working for Triad, I would never have had the opportunity. But it's being able to develop programs and, you know, it's helping in the MH world, it's helping the dealers and the consumers and all that kind of stuff. But really, I mean, I've learned a lot of patience. That's my big thing, because nothing happens overnight. And sometimes the wheels just fall off after you've put a lot of time into it. But really, the thing is that I've learned that if you just stick with it, eventually it's going to work out. It might not start out the way you first intended it to, or it might, you know, might look a little bit different, but really the things that I've been able to do just in the last, you know, 8 years have been really beneficial to Triad and to the people that I work with, and certainly to me, from a professional standpoint. But, you know, it's, I think just patience and just not be afraid to just step out of your comfort zone and make something happen.
And speaking of comfort zones, one of the things, and we have a lot of salespeople that listen to this podcast and watch this program, because they're always looking for one or two keys that can help them to become more successful. And for those people that may be listening or perhaps watching right now, what might be something that you believe in and that you utilize that could perhaps help those that are watching to help increase their sales performance?
I think for me, aside from being the fact that I love a challenge and being patient and moving forward on something, I think the thing that I have learned is, and it's something that, you know, your parents tell you, treat people the way you want to be treated.
Yeah.
And in this industry, it's even as big as it is, it's small. And if you don't have your, you know, you have to maintain your reputation and be good to people. And I mean, I think that that's what I've learned. Be truthful in what you do. And I mean, I think that people respect me, and I think that I treat people absolutely the way I want to be treated, and I'm kind to people and all that. And I know it's kind of hokey, but I think that that's why I'm successful, because I'm nice to people.
Yeah. And they look at you and they know that what you're telling them, they can pretty much take to the bank. And this
I in this industry, you can't make promises that you can't keep, certainly, because it's someone's livelihood, or it's their personal castle, you know. I mean, you have to do what you say you're gonna do. And that's a big deal. But you know, if people ask you for help, or if you you know, anything that you get involved in, you know, see it through and just be good. Don't welcome competition.
Yeah.
You know, don't try to backstab. Don't try to do anything. Just, you know, you're going to be successful if you're nice, right?
So yeah, absolutely. Just like you. Well, okay. Speaking about being successful. And so if we can help anybody out there who wants to become more successful, or people that say, wow, this Mary Beth, she's pretty cool. And I want to learn more. I want to learn more about what she and Triad has to offer. Let us know, first off, how do we get a hold of you, Mary Beth, if we have questions, if we want some tips?
Well, you can always, we have a website, and it's www.triadfs.com. I can be reached at I'm actually, you know, working remotely still. Sure. So I can be reached at 1-800-522-2013. And I'm extension, 1234. The best way to reach me, though, is my home office, which is 401-349-0779. And one other thing that I just wanted to mention is it's something that the leadership at Triad has, they have been very supportive in this, is that if there are dealers out there, and there are dealers that are insurance agents, if there are licensed dealers that would like to work with us, if they, you know, if they say, geez, you know, this flood program sounds great, contact me, because we work with dealers all the time. We can do a revenue sharing kind of thing. We're all in this together. So it's, you know, it's, again, it's not about the competition. It's how can we help each other? So please reach out to me if you have any questions about the programs that we do, or if I can help you in any way, or just to say hello.
Mary Beth, listen, I want to thank you. We've been talking a long time about doing this program.
And I've chickened out a few times.
Oh no, it's been an absolute joy. I knew it would be fun for you. It certainly has been a joy for me. I want to thank you again for coming, for being a part of this, and for all of those of you out there who want to see this again, please go to my website, go to callkencorbin.com if you want to email me, but you've got to watch this. You've got to see it again. You've got to listen to what Mary Beth has to say. And on behalf of Mary Beth and on behalf of myself, I want to thank each and every one of you for watching this edition of the Manufactured Home Show. Goodbye.
Thank you.